Welcome back to Linux Network. The Solus team has recently released Solus 4.6, nicknamed Convergence, which brings a fresh update to the Linux distribution. This new version is packed with improvements including updated desktop environments, a new naming convention for installation files, enhanced hardware support, and several under-the-hood changes. So, let's break it down. The latest version of Solus has introduced a slight change in how the installation files are named. Each ISO now includes the release channel and the generation date, making it easier for users to identify the exact build they're downloading. This adjustment helps users keep track of their versions, especially when looking for the latest feature or stability improvements. Solus 4.6 is available with several desktop environments, each offering a unique user experience. The Budgie desktop, known for its simplicity and elegance, has been updated to version 10.9.2. It continues to focus on being stable and polished. This version includes small improvements to further refine the user experience. To keep the visual style consistent, Solus has switched some default apps. Many GNOME applications like the PDF Viewer and Image Viewer have been replaced with X apps, which are simpler and easier to integrate into Budgie. XReader replaces Evins, this is a PDF viewer. XViewer replaces Eye of GNOME, this is an image viewer. Ngrama replaces File Roller, which is an archive manager. The GNOME edition of Solus now comes with GNOME 46.5. It introduces the following features. Global Search makes it easier to find apps and files directly from the desktop. Enhanced File Manager improvements in the File Manager and offers a smoother experience. You can now connect your Microsoft OneDrive account directly with GNOME, making it easier to sync and access cloud storage. Solus 4.6 supports RDP, short for Remote Desktop Protocol, enabling users to connect to remote computers right from their GNOME environment. The KDE Plasma Edition has been upgraded to Plasma 6.1.5. This makes it ideal for users who want the newest features and a customizable interface. Plasma in Solus 4.6 continues to support Wayland, a modern display server protocol that offers smoother graphics and better support for high-resolution displays. Latest KDE apps. It includes updates to the KDE software suite, such as KDE Gear 24.8.1 and KDE Frameworks 6.6.0. Offering a comprehensive set of productivity tools. For those who prefer a lightweight desktop, XFCE 4.18 is available as a beta offering. While not as polished as the other options, it's great for users who want a simple and resource-efficient environment. XFCE uses Parole for a video playback and includes XReader for PDF viewing. Other default apps like Mousepad, a text editor, and Tunar, a file manager, are updated to the latest versions. The kernel is the core of the Linux operating system, and Solus 4.6 gives users two options to match their needs. Linux Kernel 6.10.13. This is the default choice for users who want the latest features and hardware support. And Linux Kernel 6.6.54, LTS. If stability is your priority, the long-term support kernel may be a better choice. It is designed for users who don't need the latest kernel updates but prefer a more reliable experience. In terms of drivers, Solus focuses on supporting a wide range of hardware out of the box. This is especially important for users with newer graphics cards or devices. The Solus team has decided to remove certain patches called App Armor patches from the main kernel version, making maintenance easier for the developers. While this change means snaps, a type of software packages, are now less secure, flatpaks are still fully supported and preferred for installing third-party applications. Mesa is the software that helps your computer render graphics, making it particularly important for gamers or anyone using graphic-intensive applications. Solus 4.6 includes Mesa 24.2.3, which offers new features like better Vulkan support. Updates to Vulkan, a technology that enhances graphics performance, make games run smoother and look better on AMD and Intel graphics cards. New shader cache. This improvement helps reduce the time it takes for gamers and other applications to start by storing commonly used graphical data. These updates means that users with AMD or Intel GPUs can expect better performance, especially when gaming or using 3D applications. One of the significant behind-the-scenes changes in Solus 4.6 is the completion of a process called USR Merge. This technical update makes the way files are organized in Solus more similar to other Linux distributions like Fedora. It's also necessary for systemd, software that manages how your computer starts up and manages services, to work correctly in the future versions. For users, this means greater compatibility with newer software and easier updates in the long run. If you install Solus 4.6 from a fresh ISO, your system will already be using this new file structure. Managing software on Solus 4.6 has become even more flexible. Solus Software Center. This is the primary tool for finding and installing software directly from the Solus repositories. For those who prefer a different software manager, Solus offers experimental support for GNOME software for GNOME and Budgie users and KDE Discover for Plasma users. These tools make it easy to install both native packages and Flatpaks. FlatHub is pre-configured as a source for Flatpak apps, giving users access to a wide range of third-party applications. As with any new release, there are few known issues in Solus 4.6. In Plasma Edition, when setting up Wi-Fi, users need to create a KWallet key file before they can connect to networks. Running a check on the Linux kernel or LTS kernel may show them as broken, even though they work fine. These errors can be safely ignored. Users with NVIDIA graphics card may encounter problems like a black screen after waking their systems from sleep when using the 6.10 kernel. Running GNOME in a virtual machine can sometimes lead to a blank screen. This issue is intermittent and may not affect all users. All around, Solus 4.6 Convergence is an appealing release for users who want a Linux distribution that balances modern features with stability. The updates to Budgie, GNOME and KDE Plasma make this a versatile choice, no matter which desktop environment you prefer. With this focus on easy software management, improved hardware support and a more consistent user experience, Solus 4.6 aims to offer something for everyone. For those already using Solus, the upgrade to 4.6 offers meaningful improvements without the hassle of a complete overhaul. And if you're considering trying Solus for the first time, this release represents a polished and accessible entry point into the world of Linux. Whether you're a gamer, a developer, or just looking for a user-friendly operating system, Solus 4.6 may be the right fit for you. And as always, if you find this video useful, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.